Morning students, yesterday we saw how to find the values of trigonometric ratios for specific angles like 30, 45 and 60. Today we will see for two more angles, which is 0 and 90, which is actually very important. Look at how we can find the value of all trigonometric ratios for angle 0 and 90. First we take this. So how to start this particular concept? Look at. First we take a right angle triangle. Suppose it is A, it is B, it is C. And this is a small picture front of you. Now we want to do something. Actually, the condition is you want to form the trigonometric ratios for angle 0, meaning this should be acute angle. Yesterday we saw we had a 45 here, 30 here, 60 here. So one by one we took these angle acute angle, like these angle must be 45, or this angle must be 60 or 30, something like that. For getting 60 we took the equilateral triangle. For getting 45 we took the isosceles right angle triangle, and as far as 60 30 degrees concerned, when we did the concept of 60 degree, we had also a 30 degree, and same we did all, you remember that. But this angle must be this angle particular, meaning if you're finding the values of trigonometric ratios for 0, this angle must be 0. But this is not 0, you can see it is not a 0. So first of all, we should think that how it can be make 0. So look at some position of C, and what I'm doing going to do this time, if C, A is an acute angle, this is a perpendicular, this is a base, this is a hypotenuse, and this is the main picture. But A is not 0. So how we can make A 0? Look at, if I move to C towards B, if I move to C towards B, what will happen? It will happen like C will come, suppose here, so new picture will form, and try to understand this time C will be like that, angle deduced. You have to see and try to create the mentality. What I'm trying to say, you, A must be 0 because I'm going to find all the trigonometric ratios for angle 0. So this angle must be 0. This time it is not so. We want to deduce it. So how it can be deduced? You have to transfer to C towards B slowly and slowly. Suppose C comes in this position here. So this picture will come. This picture will come. A deduced. Now again, if you see A is not 0. So again I will move to C near to the B. It will be like that. Look at the thing. Look at the thing. Now I ask you that still B is 90 but A is not 0. So I want to ask you that now you have understood that this is A which is not 0. This is A which is not 0. This is now actually closer to 0 but it is not 0. How it will become 0? When C will on the B. When slowly C will on the B, C and B will be coincides like that. The situation will be this is A, this is B, and this is only C. Now C coincide to the B. Now if I ask you what angle this is, so this angle be 90. Sorry, this angle be 0. This angle is acute angle, deduce and closer to 0. Now it has been 0. What happened when I created angle A0, then what happened? When I created angle A0, then I saw that B and C are coincides. B and C are coincide, meaning AB and AC are coincide, and CB ledged. CB, I ask you that what is C to B distance? This one. Now C to B distance, this one. Now C to B distance, this one. And now CB gonna 0. Then I saw that CB completely demolished, meaning CB has been, and CB has been, and I ask you one thing again. This is A, not 0, CB exist. This is A, angle A, not 0, CB exist. This angle A, smaller to 0, still CB exists. Now angle A 0, CB, distance CB gone. CB is equal to 0. And what more happened? This time distance to AB and distance to AC are equal because this point is coincide. I ask you, what is distance AB and what is distance AC? One should reply, AB and AC are equal. So hope for particular A equal to 0, we have created these two important result, and the conclusion what we got, based on that we will find the all trigonometric ratios. Students, you have a main picture, this is, and we have created the condition when A will be 0, what two condition will happen? CB will be 0 and AB equal to AC. Now go through this and take an answer. First, sine of A. So don't see here because you can't catch anything here. This is only the right angle triangle. Now A is what? A will be 0, then the condition will follow. A will be 0, condition follow. Sine A meaning perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Now A will be 0. Perpendicular is what? BC. BC upon hypotenuse is what? AC. AC. And look, when A is equal to 0, what will happen? BC or CB, whatever. CB is equal to 0. CB will be 0. What will have? Sine 0 degree equal to BC is equal to 0 upon whatever AC. Answer will be sine 0 is equal to that 0. Because 0 upon AC is equal to itself to 0. Very good criteria. This is a condition sine A. Now if I go with a cos A. Cos A meaning base upon hypotenuse. I will go with cos 0. As I put cos 0, base and hypotenuse, say first base is equal to AB. And hypotenuse is equal to CA. CA. Now look at the thing. AB is equal to, look at AB equal to AC, AB equal to AC. So AB is equal to AC upon AC or CA, whatever it is. When they will cancel, guys, it is a 1. AC and AC cancel by 1. So you got a cos 0. Now furthermore, you need a 3 things very importantly. Tan of A is equal to perpendicular upon base. So tan, if I will put a 0, what is perpendicular? This is BC upon base is what? AB. Now look at the thing. What will happen? Tan of 0. What is BC? Search BC is equal to 0. And AB is itself AB. When I divide, I'll get again 0. So three important things you have got. And don't worry, further are very important and very simple. Sine 0, now keep remember. Sine 0, this. Cos 0, this. Tan 0, this. Now furthermore, you know if you want to find cot 0, you don't have to find that base upon perpendicular and so on. You know this is a reciprocal of tan, cos and sine. Cot is a reciprocal of tan. You must know this is 0, this is 0. The reciprocal of 0 meaning infinite. If this is 0, look at this is 0, upon anything you can write. When you do the reciprocal 1 upon 0, and one should know when upon comes in, the 0 comes in and downside denominator in upon, it always not exist value. It always not exist value, not defined value. Some in some book it is not exist, in some book it is written not ND. ND meaning not defined, in some book it is directly written infinity. I would write infinity. Infinity meaning not defined number. Why it is happening? Because it is a reciprocal of 0. So keep in mind two things. For future, the reciprocal of 0 is infinity and the reciprocal of infinity is 0. So keep remembering in mind these two things. Okay, now cot, further this is a sec. Sec 0 is a reciprocal of cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. Sec 0 is also 1 because the reciprocal of 1 is 1. And lastly it is a cosec 0. Cosec 0 is equal to again the reciprocal of sine 0, which is 0. That means infinite. So now these are all the values of sine 0, cos 0, tan 0 and cot, sec and cos respectively. This is a concept. I think you have got these four conditions and hope you got the answer. This is very simple and interesting also. So this is the condition. Now I'll go on a 90 degree. Along with that I want to tell you, same condition will appear definitely. How we can do it? 90, look at, I tell you. Suppose this is a, I'm telling you for 90. for 90 degree. Look at it. This is again the right angle triangle I'll form here. Definitely ABC, suppose A here, B here, same picture I'll make. And think that this is 90. Sorry, this time B was here, I think. No matter at all. You can take anything anywhere. This is angle in acute angle. So in last question, when we formed the formula for a particular zero, I tried to make A zero. Now I have to make A 90. It's very interesting this. How we can make A 90? Look at some picture. This time, last time when I wanted A zero, I actually moved C towards B. I moved C towards B so that A reduced closer to 0 and get 0. Now this time I want to make A90. So how will make it? Actually we moved A towards B. Look at, I tell you that CB will be same. And now A is moving towards B. Suppose A comes here, so it will be like that. Look at, try to understand. This is only, this distance is same. Now think about, A comes closer, A is greater than this, A is greater than this. Now A is still not 90. Again A comes towards here, CB will be same, and now it will be like that. I ask you that in all cases CB is same, but A is smaller, then bigger. Now if A will come, it is actually not 90 but near to 90. See for the picture, I want to make one more picture here. A comes very near to this. A comes very near to this, and suppose like that, it is CB same. In all cases, B was 90. Guys, now A is more larger, but it is not 90. When that A goes to the B, when A and B are coincide, then what will happen? B and, I ask you that, A is not 90 but very closer to 90. When A moves on B, A coincide to the B, B and A will come at a point, single point. And what about A? A will be 90 because that B was 90. Look at, B was 90, so A again gonna be 90. This time A will become a 90 degree. And now tell me that when A gonna 90, what criteria comes? Look at the things what I want to say, something. That BA distance here, then smaller, and BA 0. Now distance B to A will automatically get 0. And what two things are equal? Look at C to B distance and C to A distance. C to B, C to A. Look at C to B and C to A. Both are same because B and A are not two points. They are actually now one point because B and A are coincide. So I would say that CB and C are same. CB equal to CA. Now you just had two conclusions. These two conclusions we got after making A 90. You have to make your work on this triangle by assuming A is 90. When A will 90, these two will happen. Hope my picture you have got till here. Now I'll go with sine 90. Sine A, sorry. Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Go fast now. Say sine 90. What is perpendicular? For sine 90, perpendicular CB upon hypotenuse is AC. Now sine 90, what is CB? Look at CB equal to CA. Look at CB equal to CA. Upon CA is CA. CB equal to C and CA is CA. C and C cancel. Sine 90, you got one. First term. Now I'll go with second. Cos A base upon hypotenuse. Instead of A, I'm going to write 90 degree. So what is base now? What is base? BA. And what is hypotenuse? AC, CA, CA. Now cos 90 is equal to, put to the value, BA is equal to itself, 0. Upon whatever CA, answer is 0. You got cos 90 is equal to 0. Now we'll go on third, which is tan A. Perpendicular upon base, that tan A, instead of A, you will write 90. What is perpendicular? CB. And what is base? A perpendicular CB and base is BA. And what do you think, that CB and CA are same? Sorry. That BA is equal to 90 degree. Sorry, 0. BA is equal to 0. CB will be CB. BA is equal to 0. And unfortunately, that up in upon 0 gives it infinite. When up 0 comes in denominator, it is actually infinite. So 1090 we got. So sin 90, cos 90 and tan 90 respectively you've got. Furthermore, it is very easy. Go in cot 90. Cot 90 is reciprocal of tan 90. You know that reciprocal of infinity is 0. So cot 90 will be 0. Sec 90 is a reciprocal of cos 90. Cos 90 is 0. So reciprocal of 0 is infinite. And cosec 90 is a reciprocal of sin 90, which is 1. The reciprocal of it is 1. So these 6 values we have got. So till now, yesterday I gave the work for 30 degree. You students probably make this. And this particular for 0 and 90. Now finally we have got all the values. And we want to compile all the values in a single frame. We just want to compile all the values in single frame. And that how we can write by using some trick so that student can keep remember all these things. After completing the year after, students are not able to remember that how we can remember the values. But I have a trick to tell you that you can definitely keep in mind for the long time. So this is a very simple trick I'm telling you. Look at first sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec. These are 6 trigonometric ratios, theta, and we have some angles like 0, this is 30, this is 45, this is 60 and this is 90, and we want to make that what values here actually coming. Now I have made a table here. Now what value comes here, sin 0, don't know, sin 30 here, sin 45 here, sin 60 here, sin 90 here, what value will come? I want to tell you one thing. Look at first thing, you write only here a small trick I'm telling you. Look at and see carefully. Write here 0, write here 1, write 2, write 3 and write 4. This is a trick, student. This is a trick. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Divide by 4. Divide by 4. Divide by, excuse me. Don't make voice, please. Don't make voice. So divide by 4. Divide by 4. Divide by 4. Divide by 4. And divide by 4. So all we have divided by 4 and then after you just use a square root sign on that. Use a square root sign on that. Hope you have seen that what I made. First I read 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then divided by 4, 4, 4, 4 and 4 and use a square root. This is a trick. Now write your answers here only. 0 upon 4 is 0 right here. Meaning sin 0 equal to 0. Now look at it. Square root of 1 is 1 and square root of 4 is 2. The answer is 1 by 2. This is sin 30 1 by 2. Now here, 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Look at the thing 2 by 4. How we did it? 1s are and 2s are. So square root of 1 is 1 but square root of 2 cannot possible. So I'll write only square root of 2. Like that. So sin 45 is 1 by root 2. Now sin 60 here. 3 have a square root, not having a particular square root, but 4 having a square root 2. This is a sin of 60. And sin of 90 is cancelled to 4 and 4 will have a 1. 4 and 4, 1. So finally we got sin 0, sin 30, sin 45, sin 60 and sin 90. And this is very simple now how to get it. You will never forget that how we can find the values. You will definitely keep remember always. Now furthermore how we can do it, I tell you. Look at, now you just reverse the cycle, write 1 here, write 3 by 2 here, write same, write this here and write this here. This is very simple. Now what about the next, you know that tan is equal to sin upon cos, so just do divide this value by this, this value by this, this value by this, and so on. Sin theta upon cos theta equal to tan theta. So you just have to divide 0 upon 1, 1 upon under 1 upon 2 upon 3 by 2, 2 and 2 cancel. Sorry, 2 and 2 cancel. Here under 2 under 2 cancel. Here 2 and 2 cancel. And 1 upon 0, 1 upon 0 infinite. You know that in upon 0 it is infinite. What about cot? You know now. Cot is a reciprocal of 10. Cot is a reciprocal of 10. So do the reciprocal of all the value, you will get values of cot. Like this is 0. So reciprocal of 0 is infinite. Reciprocal of this is root 3. Reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of this is 1 by root 3. And reciprocal of infinite is 0. Now go in cos and sec. The reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of this is 2 by root 3. Reciprocal of this is root 2. Reciprocal of this is 2. And reciprocal of 0 is infinite. And about last, sine and cosec are reciprocal to each other. A 0 reciprocal is infinity. This is a 2. This is a root 2. This is 2 by root 3. And this is a 1. So this is a simple table now I found. And I think you won't forget all these things. So hope it is good enough for the day. Now you do practice to do all from 0 to 90 how we can find the value of trigonometric ratios. Okay, thank you.